take your own words, that if I really take your words, you have mentioned somewhere that Syriac Bible preserves the ancient Bible or biblical legacy. How do you justify this sentence? And probably the audience would like to listen from a background of some one or two more questions, that what is the origin of Syriac scriptural tradition? These are two real connected questions. Again, how do you explain it, center frames gospel of Diatessaron or the Evangelion and the Mahalte? So it's all combined together.
Yes. So the justification that the Syriac Bible represents an ancient biblical heritage is basically because the Syriac Peshitta Bible is a very early translation of the scriptures. If we go to the Old Testament or the Hebrew Bible, the Peshitta or the Syriac version represents the Hebrew Bible of the first and second century. And we even have ancient manuscripts that prior to the discoveries of the Dead Sea Scrolls are more ancient than any Hebrew manuscript. We have Hebrew, we have Syriac manuscripts of the Hebrew Bible, dated manuscripts that go back to the 5th and the 6th century. We probably have some manuscript, maybe undated, that may even go to the 4th century. But definitely we have manuscripts from the 5th and the 6th century of the scriptures. So they represent a very early rendition of the Hebrew Bible into the Syriac language. That's as far as the Hebrew Bible or the Old Testament is concerned. As far as the New Testament is concerned, in particular the Gospels, you have the Evangelion, the Gospel of the Mixed, which was the version of the Gospels that was popular amongst the Syriac users during the time of Saint Ephrem. This version of the Bible is quite ancient. It is a mixture of the four Gospels into one narration. And its importance is in the fact that it draws not only from the canonical Greek Gospels, that is the canonical Greek Gospels that came down to us, but it draws on pre-canonical texts. And that's where the importance of these Gospels lies, in the fact that it draws on this extra biblical material that got filtered out once the canonical Greek Gospels took hold. And the Gospels of the time of Saint Ephrem are the earliest form that we know in Syriac. And later on came the Evangelion Demfarshe, the separated ones, that is Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. So that is the justification to the claim that Syriac represents an ancient biblical legacy. And this is why, if you look at the Bible, Bible that is produced in any language, in English, in German, in French, that is a scholarly Bible, it is always, in its footnotes, you will always find references to the Syriac, because it is considered one of the primary early versions of the Bible.
Thank you. I think that gives us a very good light in terms of center frames Bible, of combining all these four Gospels. But in between that explanation, you have mentioned about another word, Old Syriac Version Bible. Is it the same that you're talking about, the four Gospels together of a center frame, and this Old Syriac Version, are the same?
So basically the progression goes from the mixed Gospel, which is the Gospel that Saint Ephrem wrote a commentary on, And then it goes to the four separated Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, which develops until it comes to the version that we now call Peshitto. Of course, the old Syriac, which is the one in between the Diatas Run and the Peshitto, is a Bible that we only learned about in the 19th century. It is something that we did not know about. And when the Western scholars discovered it and realized that its text is pre-Peshitto, it comes before the Peshitto, they called it the Old Syriac Gospels. The Syriac fathers did not call it the Old Syriac Gospels, it was just the Gospels, but they called it the Mferşe in order to distinguish it from the Mhalte. The Mhalte is the mixed, the one narration, and the Mferşe is the separated, that means four separate Gospels. So it's in between.
Okay, thank you. That clears some doubts. You know, most of the time we have this term, Old Syriac version of the Bible. Probably something very much connected to that. Would you kindly give us some brief highlights about the Peshitta, or what you talk about the Old Syriac version of the Bible? And is it the same that Blessed Philoxenus of Marburg, or maybe in later we called as a Harkel translation, Thomas Harkel translation? What are the difference between these old translations of Bible?
Yeah, so the earliest form of the Old Testament is what we call the Peshitto now, and as far as the New Testament, what came after the Old Syriac is what we call Peshitta. Peshitta means simple, and the name at the time, of course, did not exist. You mentioned two versions, that of Philoxenus of Marburg and of Thomas of Harkal, the Harklean.
Yes.
Let's talk about them so that we can understand why we are calling the one that we have in our hands Peshitta, simple. So Mor Philoxenus of Marburg wanted to use a version of the Bible for theological reflections and for theological discussions, especially in the context of the Christological controversies of the 5th and 6th century, Chalcedonian versus non-Chalcedonian. Okay. Philoxenus felt that the New Testament, the Peshitta, what we call now the Peshitta New Testament, of course it wasn't called that at the time. He felt that because it was made in a free manner in order to make it very clear Syriac, he felt that in order to do theological discussions and argumentations, he needed a version in Syriac that is extremely literal with respect to the Greek, letter for letter or word for word, let's say. So he commissioned one of his core episcopos named Polycarp to make this translation, and we call it the Philoxenian. Okay. Unfortunately, apart from the writings of Mor Philoxenus that survive and quoted, we don't have much that is left from it, but it was not meant for us to read it in church, and that's why it does not survive. It was supposed to be an academic exercise. It was a resource for theologians to use. So they wanted it to be very, very close to the Greek. The Greek, of course, of the time of Mor Philoxenus. The Peshitto is based on the Greek of the earlier centuries, 3rd, 4th century, while that of Mor Philoxenus is based on the Greek of the 5th and the 6th century, the later times. Then came the version of Thomas of Harkel, which was a revision of the Philoxenus version to make it even closer and closer to the Greek. During the time of Thomas, there was a new style of translation, what we call literal translation or mirror translation. That means if there is a word in the Greek or a preposition or a prefix, I want to represent it in the Syriac.
Okay.
Of course, anybody who does translation, if you take Malayalam and you want to translate it into English, and your main objective is to represent the Malayalam prefixes and suffixes, you end up with very weird English.
Yes.
And this is what the result was, very weird Syriac.
Mm-hmm.
And this Syriac was complicated because it was weird Syriac. It was really as if it was Greek in a Syriac dress. Because this one was complicated, by the 9th century, people began to call the version that we have in our hands now the simple one. That is the simpler, the easier to read. Pshitto or Pshitta in East Syriac. And that's where the name comes. It comes much later when people say, okay, this is not the complicated one that is so difficult to read. This is the easy one to read. So we're going to call it the Pshitta version.